All right, everybody. Hello. Today I would like to give you an update on my watch collection, my future plans, my thoughts, my ideas, and I would be glad to learn about your ideas. What would you do by having this kind of watches in your collection? Maybe you would like to shrink it down a little bit. But before we start the discussion, let me give you an update on the current status of my collection. Let's start with some cradle watches. And I would like to start with my first investment, the Blancpain 57s. That's my first cradle watch that I purchased, and I have it now for almost 10 years in my collection. I'm still excited by the original design and by the bezel action. Very smooth, very precise, as you would expect it from this kind of watch. I like dive watches, so I have another diver, which was purchased last year, the Tudor Blancpain Black Heritage Edition. That's the one with the in-house movement. Also very nice watch. Extremely nice bezel action. Quite traditional design. Proceeding with an all-time classic. My little Speedmaster Professional manual wind watch. I think this kind of watch should be in every collection. It's an all-time classic. I decided for the version with the Heslite crystal. For me, it's more traditional, more classic feeling, and that goes fine with a suit. That goes fine for the weekend. This watch is amazing. I really like it. From time to time, I'm also wearing an Apple Watch. That one is in Series 3, ceramic edition, including cellular. What I like about this watch, so first of all, I think the Series 3 now fulfills all the promises the first Apple Watch should have brought with it. Build quality is outstanding. I like the strap change mechanism. And is especially for business occasions, it's pretty good. You can check your messages without staring at the cell phone. You can have two time zones on it. It's pretty convenient, but yeah, I have one major problem. I'm addicted to mechanical watches, so the wrist time of the Apple Watches, let's say, yeah, maybe one day per week maximum. I'm a big fan of Seiko, and as you know from my other videos, I have two turtles. That's the Blue Lagoon Turtle Limited Edition on the steel bracelet. What's good about Seiko is that you have an in-house movement, an original design. The build quality is pretty good for the money that you have to pay for it. It's unique. Reliable, yeah, I just like Seiko. My latest acquisition was the Turtle Black Series, the black coated turtle. So far, after 1 week of wrist time, I'm pretty happy with it. It's a turtle, and if you can get one, get one. From time to time, you also need something classic, and therefore I bought the Seiko Presage Cocktail Time. This one is gold plated, made in Japan. Very traditional appearance. I like the watch a lot. The only issue, it's not really an issue, but if this watch would be a little bit smaller, like 39 millimeter, then I think it would be even better. But it's precise, it's the dial is amazing. Yeah. Another watch that I can really recommend. My only vintage watch in the collection is a King Seiko, high beat movement, and it's a pretty small watch. Nevertheless, I think it works fine with a business dress. It's very precise, reliable. I recently serviced it at Seiko Germany, and since that time it runs like hell again. It has this nice golden medallion at the backside, and yeah, quite classic design. Something cheap from Switzerland, the System 51. What is interesting about this watch is that it's an mechanical movement which is done by machines, so it's an this watch is not made by hand. Mechanical movement, 51 parts. That was the first generation System 51. I think in the meantime they also offer metal options. It's a nice fun watch. Yeah. Nothing special. For sure, there is also some room for digital watches. The Casio F91W, also quite classical one, very small one, reliable one. Cost you around $10. Yeah, that's a must. The same one is also available in steel. Some scratches already, but yeah, nevertheless. This plastic watch is also known as the Osama bin Laden watch. And I got the present recently from my father. This is an Ascania German made watch. I think they're using an ETA movement here inside. It's a quite original design. I've never seen this kind of case shape with another brand. Bezel action is a little bit stiff, but it works fine. That's a pretty large size watch with a huge crown on it. I think the most comfortable way to wear it is on a NATO strap. That's the current situation of my collection. And now, what should I do? I'm looking to get in Daytona from Rolex, but that's a very tough task, so it seems that it's almost impossible without paying a premium for such a watch. I've also considered to sell all my Seiko watches and buy a new Seiko, a Marine Master 300 or a Grand Seiko, but that's not yet decided. What's for sure is that I will keep the Speedmaster, I will keep my Blancpain, and I will keep my Blancpain. All the other watches might be sold, but yeah. I'm not sure, I'm pretty unsure about this. Let me know about your ideas. What should I do? Should I keep them? Should I sell them? Please let me know. I'm looking forward to get any feedback. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.